One of the biggest ways that proficiency-based learning has shifted things in my classroom is allowing me to really clearly identify the learning target for the marking period and to ensure that whatever I'm teaching is directly related to that target. I feel like the biggest thing that works is that I've identified what my students are going to learn, and I've articulated that to my students so that the playing field is really level.
The big goal here is we know we've been working on this idea of how to structure effect function in molecules. Your summative, which will come in next Monday, is your lab analysis. And our goal today is to get everyone in a position where you can analyze your data so fully that you could get a 4, right? So that you understand exactly what you need to do to hit that level of mastery.
So this unit is about the relationship between structure and function in biological molecules. And the learning target is that I'm asking students to analyze data and through their analysis explain the relationship between structure and function in enzymes.
Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna do a little demo in the back of the room. We'll have to cluster around the lab table. The demonstration is gonna get at the relationship between pH, structure, and function. And so it's a chance for us to sort of freely talk about what's happening outside the lens of doing like a really serious lab. We're just gonna look at a simple reaction and talk about it. Okay.
So in AP Biology today, we are near the end of the marking period. Students are going to be, they're very close to being ready for their summative. We've already had 4 formative assessments. And today I want to help students be able to absolutely be at proficient. And if not be at proficient, I want to help them get to the exemplary level of performance.
So we have been working on this idea of structure and function in molecules. And then last week, we worked on a lab where we altered the pH of the environment.
I'm going to provide them with a demonstration for just another way to look at the material. Sometimes a new perspective is really important for developing a concept, especially if you're feeling stuck.
So is it the product or the byproduct?
The byproduct.
That allowed my students to have this really visual, non-lab based experience where they saw the structure of a protein change in response to pH. And so we used that really tangible, kind of lighthearted example as a way to then connect back to what was happening in the lab.
Here's the plan. I'll talk to you about how you can use the demo that we just did to make some revisions to what you did for class today. And you'll get a chance to share that work with a trusted classmate, and they'll be able to give you some feedback on it. And remember that when you're reading your classmate's work, that is a great, like, it's a privilege, right? Because somebody is showing you their work, and you might also learn as you're reading it, oh, they did a really nice job of explaining our group interactions. I just learned something by reading this.
The entire purpose of giving students the rubric on day one of the unit is so that they know what the learning target is and what they need to do to achieve certain levels on that rubric. And so we work on reading it, and we work on understanding what does it take to get to a 3, to a proficient level, and what does it take to get to an exemplary level. And so that rubric is a teaching tool in the classroom, and we use it to help articulate what proficient means and what beyond proficient means.
I do want you to use this chart. We'll focus mostly on the content target. See where you think they are on the scale. So do you think they're at a 3 or at a 4? And if they're at a 4, it's because of that significant relevant evidence, okay?
As part of my unit development, I try to include peer-to-peer assessment at least once or twice. So as a teacher, I clarify the learning target. As the student, they work on demonstrating their ability to have mastery of that learning target. So can you look at a peer's work and identify that they are proficient or that they are beyond proficient? And so one, it helps students clarify the target for themselves. It also helps students see this is what a 4 looks like. This is what a 3 looks like. And one of the things in proficiency-based learning is that we are charged with articulating that. We're charged with taking the mystery out of what does it take to be excellent. And so if I can offer students an example where they can look at each other's work and see this is exemplary, I think that's where the learning can come together for students.
And yeah, it was really good.
I just thought there was one part that I was like really good, because I'm pretty sure that that the enzyme doesn't denature hydrogen peroxide.
Students have a pretty solid idea of what, at this point in the unit, of what proficiency means. And so to be proficient, they're looking for one of their peers to describe that the structure of an enzyme relates to its function. And when they see proficiency, they can observe in their peer's writing that the person has said something along the lines of, the enzyme has worked. To be at a 4, they're gonna see their peer write something that suggests at a deeper level why the enzyme is working optimally or not.
How about you, Katy?
I really need to work on explaining like details about like our groups and like the function, just to make it like more clear and so you can understand it, because I just kind of left it like really vague.
And I feel like you were able to say that verbally to me.
Yeah, when we were.
Do you feel like you understand it?
Yeah. But it's just like writing.
Yeah. Okay. So it's, I feel like I know that you know it, but let's make sure it gets on there. How about you guys?
I think the biggest challenge is feeling like I have to be incredibly intentional about the lessons that I'm creating. So if I have a particular learning target, structure and function in molecules, my lesson has to directly relate to that learning target, which means that gone are any lessons that you use that might be cursorily related. And so I think it requires a lot of intention in your instructional design, and our current system, not just at Montpelier High School, but probably nationwide for teachers, is that there's not enough planning time to create those intentional lessons. So you're still working far outside of school hours to create these really well-designed lessons. But proficiency requires well-designed lessons. My teaching philosophy is to mix up the mode of learning. So a little bit of instruction, a demonstration, group work, independent work. And largely that's because we have 80-minute classes, which I love. I love that I have that much time with my students, but I also really feel intentional about mixing up the ways in which students are spending their time.